All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, get ready. We're here at the Roy and Jimmy thing. Get ready to rock, get ready to roll. The moment you've all been waiting for. We got hot, sexy Roy and Jimmy. Hell yeah, yo.
Welcome into the Roy and Jimmy thing here on chaoticradio.com. Tuesday night, birthday edition, our birthday week. My name is Roy Brewster. This is...
I am Jimmy Shaw. It is chaoticradio.com, the home of the Roy and Jimmy thing, your new Tuesday night guys.
Are we still new?
Well, no. We've been here, what, 3.5 years?
No, I mean new for Tuesday.
Newer for Tuesday.
Oh, newer.
New and improved, lemon-scented.
Scents might be wearing off, though.
Right.
But we're still new.
We're still new today, right here.
We got our new graphic. Happy birthday to us.
Exactly. It's that time of year again. It's birthday week. Roy's always a week away from me. He just hit his. Mine's this next week. So this week... it's birthday week. Good evening, gents. Oh, chat on her YouTube isn't working. Evan, you did show up. I saw that, buddy.
The chat was working. There it is. Yeah. Good evening, gents. Oh, yeah, it's working.
So anyway, there's Evan. He showed up, him and the wife, right?
They did show up, and here we go. We gave away some kudos pizza, you know, for email addresses and that kind of cool stuff afterwards.
Absolutely.
Guess who wins?
Evan.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Speaking of kudos, that's our sponsor. We are proudly brought to you by Kudos Pizzeria, two locations, Upland, California, and also the newest one, Rancho Cucamonga, Milliken and 4th.
They're up and running and flying.
They're up, running, flying. Go check out their YouTube page. No, not YouTube page. Go check out their Facebook page, facebook.com. Look up Kudos Pizzeria, both locations. Upland is Foothill and Grove. And, as I said, Ranch Cucamonga, the new shiny location at Milliken
like,
and 4th.
Just like we're shiny on Tuesdays?
Exactly.
They're a little more shiny than we are.
Exactly.
Little more.
Yes.
And so. all the people in the liking and doing everything, we've got Nikki, Dennis, Rick, Paul, Erica, Burton, Donna. Oh, look, there's Dilip. I haven't seen him in a while.
Who?
Dilip.
Dillip, what's up, Dillip?
We used to do Ice House shows with him all the time.
Yes, the Winkers. Billy, what's up, buddy? There's Nikki. Nikki, what's up? I hope you're not at the gym. I hope you're kicking it right now.
I would hope so. Happy to you again, and tell Jimmy happy birthday too. Love us both.
It is birthday week because Nikki just had one.
She had one too. She's a day before I was.
Well,
she tried to move in on my business because we're kind of related. She tried to move in on my stuff, take it all up,
stealing your thunder there.
I said no.
None.
I told her mom, Eileen, you better push that thing out early.
You better get this over with because it's my turn.
Yeah, that's what I did.
It is my turn right now.
Tell your mom hi, too. I mean, I just told her to push one out. You probably should probably tell her that.
Yeah, probably not. No. No, you should not.
Yeah, that wasn't good.
So we had a busy weekend.
Yes.
We had Roy was down there at the world-famous Legacy Room in Chino, California for another edition of the Roy and Jimmy Thing Presents Laughs at the Legacy.
That was a lot of fun. Thanks to, we had Gus, and we had Travis, and we had Lila, and we had Ann, and then Sean brought it home to the headline. Awesome show.
The lovely and talented Sean Williams.
Lovely and talented.
We had to keep it that way just because of that ladies headliner thing.
So but he was the first one to break the mold.
He broke the mold. The lovely and talented Sean Williams, breaking the man headliner situation.
Yeah, but he's got a good rack, so he can get away with it.
Oh, sure. And the ass on him.
Ooh.
Will not stop.
All the way. I couldn't even respond.
You couldn't do that one, right?
I was going to respond and make something funny, but you just cracked me up.
And also, though, we are talking, this is our birthday week, but we also have friends and family with birthdays this week.
Yes.
And let's see here. We have tomorrow our buddy Oso, his birthday, Matthew Moore. Troy Rawlings, good guy over there on LA Radio now. And let's see here, what else? Thursday, Desiree Downs, Randy Swenson, a little Foothill Knowles kind of guy right there. That's it. Oh, I'm reading, you know, there's so many people I don't know that are actually on here. Friday is our buddy Keith Michael Ashton. We have Saturday. Anyone I know on Saturday? Nope.
Last Saturday was Nikki.
Don't be mad, but Saturday I do not.
Saturday you do not?
Saturday I do not, but that's our upcoming birthdays for friends, fans, and family and all that.
Friends, fans, and family.
And I have to give a shout out to the lovely and talented friend of the show, Rosie Tran.
Yes, how was that?
That was great. She killed it. It was great. She did her CD taping and just had a blast and was hanging out with her husband in the green room. And this guy is a guy we worked with Bobby Oliver's shows, Victor Vega.
Okay.
It's his house. Okay, it's in Long Beach. It was a hall. But this guy's got this mini mansion thing. It's just gorgeous. But downstairs is a little basement. He converted it into a little showroom. Off the side is an actual green room with the wine rack and all that.
Oh.
I mean, it was pretty
nice. Well, I
saw
the picture of you in the green room.
Yeah.
I was like, wow.
Big wine rack behind there. And then just over the steps is showroom. I mean, it was fun. Hold about, I think it was like 60 people. Place was packed. Great crowd. I got to work with Keith, our buddy Keith Reza again. Bill Ward. I got to meet the infamous Bill Ward.
Yeah, how was Bill?
He's a blast. Yeah. Just a blast.
Nice?
Oh, yeah. Nice guy. Just everything you would think he is. And I got to meet a new comic, Ken Crosby. And he went up there and killed it. And, of course, I got to go up before Rosie. And, like I said, she nailed it. She probably did, like, I think, 40 minutes. Just strong, great taping. So when that drops, we'll let you guys know. And you definitely need to download that, pick that up. I don't know what form she's letting that go at.
But you're going to get it regardless.
Yeah, and her husband was the engineer. He did the whole wire hooking up and everything. This guy's like multi-talented.
The wire hooking up?
Wire hooking
up.
Is
that techie talk?
That's what I do in the booth over there. Wire hooky up.
Wire hooky up.
And then me and her husband got to have this lovely vision of Keith Reza, half of his ass.
Nice.
Which was nice, yes. Yeah. Yeah, and just end up, I guess he didn't bring a belt. But they called him up, and there was a full moon down in the green room. It's always great when that happens. But it's not always great.
I was going to say, what's so great about that?
It's always uncomfortable when that happens, but it's a pleasure when someone else sees it the same time you do.
Oh, okay.
Those kind of situations. It's like, I can tell you, if it was just me and him, and I said, dude, half his ass was hanging out, and you would say, oh, yeah, that's gross. But then you lock eyes with somebody while it's happening, and then that's where you got to keep it contained, and it's a little more, at least, enjoyable for me to see a male butt.
I did a show with Keith where he had the, I think I told you, where he had the tag of his shirt hanging off his armpit for a while.
It's so funny. But he went up there, he had a strong Dodge bit.
Did he?
Yeah, a Dodge. 2017 Dodge bit. Me and Bill Ward were on the floor.
Nice!
Yeah.
Good for him.
No, everybody, it was a very strong show. It was great. So, again, thank you, Rosie. We had a blast. Thank you, Victor, for letting us be in your house. I guess he does it once a month. Calls it Victor's Speakeasy.
Well, you know what? We were in. It wasn't as nice as that. Mm-hmm. But remember, someone named their backyard where we had a show, the Meridian,
for the street.
Right.
There was some pimp stuff, and that backyard was set up not fake grass.
I mean, not the cheap, not like carpet grass.
No,
like real cool fake grass.
Real cool fake grass, and the Meridian, and we thought it was a club,
right.
But it was the house was on Meridian.
Yeah.
But
full bar patio with the lights and everything.
Two porta potties, yeah. Male and female. I mean, the guy did it right. No one is pissing in my house.
It was awesome.
Yeah,
man.
The guy did it right. And so, yeah, so you don't say no when they say, well, it's at my friend's house. Yeah, now I'm going to compare them. I want to go.
Yeah, I want to see what you got.
I want to see what you set up to make, because if a comic set the house up, then you know that thing's going to be awesome.
Well, because a comic knows what's up.
Yeah. And right. So Victor Vega, big shout out to him for hosting that, and thanks for letting us in. It was a really fun night.
We had a question.
I did miss you guys.
Well, we missed you too.
I did miss you guys. Hadn't been at the Legacy since last year.
Was it like April-ish or May?
Yeah, April-ish, and you weren't there when I was there last, so I guess it evened out.
We had, it's true. We had, chat room wants to know if we can have Bill on our show.
Who's Bill?
Bill Ward.
Oh, absolutely. We should have Bill. That's a great idea.
And then Evan's in there saying that they had a blast, and thanks again for the pizza.
With all the pizza icons. So
I think that's how many he won.
You got to tell your dad, did you give your dad a sticker so he can have, let him know that he owns a Roy and Jimmy thing cup already?
Right.
He just has to brand it.
Right.
Yeah, everybody has one right now.
They just haven't.
We just have to, I didn't even give you the address for Ernie. We got to send Ernie his stuff. But We got to slap you slap that official sticker on there. You are branded. That is a you. Everyone has one right now.
Yes.
Roy and Jimmy thing official
it's,
mug.
It's your favorite mug.
It is your favorite mug, and that makes it our mug.
Right.
Our mug is your favorite mug.
It's like we're your favorite T-shirt.
Our official mug is your mug.
Right.
Do you get that?
It's already there.
You have it. He said, where's mine? It's in the cupboard.
It's in there already.
It's behind you.
We just got to send you the fixings.
You just got to brand it yourself. And that's how you put that sticker on. And you have, and the instructions are, Evan, slightly askew.
Yeah, he's them straight.
He has them straight. I mean,
that's okay.
Good eyeball.
Yeah, that's good.
But you have more stickers, I'm assuming.
Yeah. So he said he'll see his dad this weekend. He'll get his sticker.
Yeah, we're giving me a couple.
Okay.
Slightly askew.
A little askew. That's all right. I'll send you another one if you got to redo yours.
That's the TM on that.
Yeah.
Slightly askew. Just like, here you go.
Ready?
Where's our camera?
Camera's there. There it is. See? Just a tad. It's okay. I think it's
angled
right there.
There's a delay on the
I think it's right there.
The camera, so I'm hoping I'm this is right here. Here we go.
I'm trying to see where it is.
There we go.
It's slightly right, askew. Yeah, slightly askew.
Slightly
yeah.
askew.
That's the official. So
that's the TM on there.
That's right. One word of advice, though.
Yes.
You're going to hand wash that thing.
Yes, never. Roy did the serious R&D on this thing.
Yeah. I had it, and it looked good through the dishwasher, and then I put it in the dishwasher. And pulled it out, and I had a big white sticker on the side of the
cup. And no fault of yours. You were keeping it clean. You were keeping it tight.
Yeah. I actually put the original one on the Chaotic Radio coffee mug.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Chaotic one side, Roy and Jimmy the other.
Right.
And then it was just Chaotic on one side. No. Yeah, I need to redo. Jimmy was supposed to send me some, too. All right. We'll get you another one.
And he hand washes all the dishes.
Oh, really?
Well, okay. He was almost snowed in today, so I can understand where he doesn't have a dishwasher.
He's like a frontier man.
Yeah.
Does that stuff by hand.
He's like a beast. He goes hunting for his food and everything.
No, he doesn't. He goes to Kudos and gets his free pizza.
Yes, and had to make dinner all week.
I couldn't believe I pulled it out and it was there.
Yeah.
But we gave away a couple there. Maybe we should have told Dave and Stephanie. But, you know.
That we gave a couple away?
Yeah.
Dave wants to give all of it away.
No, not all, but almost.
Pretty much all.
Yeah. So, here's the thing. You go over there, you get yourself a little pizza,
right.
You're going to go back.
Dennis, I can cover up that atrocious Starbucks emblem on my cup, but out of stickers. Well, okay, we have to send you some.
I will send you some, too.
But my white mug at home is actually a Starbucks sticker. I covered it up.
Who wants to?
I'm not going to advertise for him.
No.
Not when I can advertise us.
Us.
I mean, we're supposed to be coming into this grand morning show eventually, so yeah.
Yeah.
Get that PR rolling.
And we could always use a little black thing on the Chaotic on the bottom. A little black Sharpie. Take that right off. Just in case we have to.
We'll have to come up with a new character if we ever do that. That way we can have a sidekick named Dutchie in honor of.
Oh, there we go.
Right, you know. Dutchie's on the phone. Ah, yeah, cracky bastard, or however that voice will go. Yeah. Well, we'll have to flesh it out.
Yeah, it's like yellow stars and green clovers, or whatever it is. I don't know how it goes.
I don't know. It's watching cricket right now.
Look at Evan. He said he's got a total of three cards now.
Jeez.
Here's the jokes on him. You can show up with that, and they're going, what's this? What? Excuse me? What? Did you print these at home?
Did he read that it expired Sunday?
Yeah, expires at the end of February. Just let you know. You got till tomorrow.
Got one day.
No, we probably stretch it out till Jimmy's birthday. So Saturday. No, I'm just kidding. I'm playing with you. You hang on to those a while. You know, I probably wouldn't even use them. I'd hold on to them.
Yeah.
Because they're going to be those things. You're going to be selling those things on eBay for thousands and thousands of dollars.
This is true.
So, I mean, you want a pizza for a few bucks, or you want thousands of dollars out of a...
Did I read right? Sorry about that.
No,
did I read right that Dennis made an appearance Saturday? Did he swing by?
Dennis showed up.
Yeah.
Said hi. It was cool to have him there, and they had to bail out.
Right. Well,
but he stopped in to say hi.
He didn't think he was going to make it at all.
Right.
He said he wasn't.
Right.
He said, I can't do it. But, you know, for him to take that effort.
That, and if you think about it, not even to enjoy the show, just right. Come by, say hi, and bail.
Little support, little bro hug here and there.
It was awesome.
Good man. Thank you so much, Dennis.
Thanks,
man.
Dennis.
Your support, well, you know, how many pizzas do you got? How many do you need is
right.
What I'm saying.
I don't know. Did you hear the phone ring?
Yeah.
I heard something.
I'm hearing ringing.
I heard. Yeah, it's ringing, but it's not ringing here.
I'm going to go peek in the window.
He's going to go peek in the window.
I'm going to go peek in the window.
We hear, hey, chain show.
Yeah, it's ringing.
Desktop director, connect show. Huh.
I see it ringing.
It's ringing. So if you're trying to call me.
I can see it from here.
Oh, hold up. Whoa, something's going on here. Look at this.
Instant message me.
Look at that. Look at this. Look at this.
In uniform and spread the love. Very good.
Wow, this is...
All right, whoever's calling, private message me on instant. Give me a Facebook message and I'll give
you... Oh, there it goes. I redid it.
There we go. Yeah, we go. We're going to try this.
We're going to try it. Line one, you're on the air. Ah, that worked awesome. Oh, wait. No, it's there.
Aw. Oh.
What?
There's a button, maybe.
There's a button. Stay with us. It's a 562. It's a 562. We don't even know who it is. Jimmy's going to see. Jimmy's normally in there, but we've decided that we can do this from. Hey, line one, you're on the air. Nope, still not there. He just gave up. Oh, hold it. Wait. Desktop director. Talent. No director. Talent. Try this.
Try it off.
Line one, you're on the air. It's got this thing. It looks like a number 5 on a dice roll now.
Ooh, God, that's lucky. Go for 7. Ariana kind of fingers crossed thing. Private message me. Hit me on Facebook Messenger and I'll give you my number. We'll get you through.
Oh, now you're gone.
Yeah, I'm not playing with this. That was our tech. That was our tech moment.
You know what? No director talent. There we go.
Yeah, try that.
That's what I did the first time.
Yeah.
So give us a call back or Facebook message. We'll get you on that way. We'll figure out how to do it. We'll get you a number to get you a call.
We'll get you through.
We'll get you through if you want to talk. It was a 562 number. We love that you called, but I don't get it. And we've had the phone company here, just so you know. The phone company was here. Everyone's here, and I can't get it. No talent. Connect show is already connected.
That is definitely the setting options for us. Definitely hit no talent.
Yeah, well, that's what you got to hit, no talent.
I know, I'm just saying it coincides with us using phones.
Yeah, well, whatever.
We would be the no talent.
Cross your fingers. Hey, well, someone sent a four-leaf clover.
Yeah,
I think that was sent for Dutchie.
Aw, in honor of.
In honor of being a little leprechaun.
So fun weekend. Thanks for the comics for killing it at the Legacy Room. Thanks for Jim, Sheila, and Paul over at the Legacy Room. Hopefully we can do that again soon.
Thank you, everybody.
Yeah, we had a great time. It was a full weekend. And then I did my black market baby drop-off on Sunday.
Yeah, did you get any money?
No, I didn't need any money. It was my pleasure.
It was your pleasure?
Pleasure to drop off and help out. The reuniting of the kids with their parents.
Well, that's good.
Up there in Kettleman City.
Yeah.
Damn, that was a drive.
How far is that?
It's 3 hours each way.
Yikes!
Yeah. Yeah, it's... And then the Long Beach drive, that was hell. Where Victor's, the speakeasy was.
Speakeasy.
Basically where the 22 stops.
Yeah.
Turn left.
So that's right by Cal State... Long Beach.
Yeah, Wade, we're 22 stops.
Yeah.
And Waze had me going the right way, and then when I left, everything was cool, but as I went, two big accidents happened, so I was in the city of Industry a few times, Bray Canyon Road, loop-de-loop a couple times, and then, of course, I got reunited with all the idiotic
drivers. Loop-de-looped around.
Explain a black baby drop-off. No, black market baby drop-off. That wasn't a black baby.
Little brown baby.
You, brown baby, become a plumber.
That was brown baby. I love that guy.
So we had Ian Begg. Yeah, absolutely. So, so we dropped them off, and that drive, and I was toast yesterday. Didn't do anything worth anything in my life. I was done. Between Long Beach Drive, Kettleman City, back and forth. There you go.
And having the kids the whole time?
The week, yeah.
Yeah.
Delightful, but... And it's really not their fault that they're this way. It's just a different way of parenting that I am not in sync with. That is, you know, it's like new math. I can't do new math, and I definitely can't parent, apparently. I found myself almost being like the dog whisperer, you know, trying to be the alpha male. Like, hey, just raise it. Hey. And so, no, it didn't happen that way. But they're cute, adorable, and...
home, thank God.
And they're home. So our job is done.
So how long is the cool Uncle Jimmy thing last for? Like, you good for like 3 days?
No, I'm going to say where I thought I was the coolest uncle. I'm actually not. And that's just a self-awareness.
Self-awareness. I'm looking back at myself.
Yeah, exactly. You know, look from outside in, and, you know, my patience level could be better. I thought it was pretty good, knowing how I am, or how I could be, or how I used to be. There was a lot of just, you know, inside voice going on. But then again, it's all new stuff. Cool Uncle Jimmy lasts 2 minutes. Yeah, yeah, it was getting near the end there, and so, yeah.
Well, okay.
At one point, I needed them to settle down, and I said, "If you don't settle down, I'm going to take it out on your aunt. She's going to get it." And yeah, it didn't work.
No, it didn't work.
They didn't care. They didn't care. It's just Aunt Arna.
I remember one of my dad's moves one time. We had someone small over. I had to be like 13 years older.
We had someone small over. You're a good Uncle Roy too. I can see that.
I was probably about 13, and they were young, and they weren't a relative, and they were going crazy, losing their shit. They're probably about 4 or 5, and Dad looked over at him and said, "You don't knock it off, I'm going to put you in the microwave." Fixed him.
That's some good. That's
solid.
That's a solid.
Now, wanted the kid to keep losing his mind.
Just to see the move.
See if you try to push him in the microwave. Yeah.
Well, it's always funny, too, when Aunt Arna is defending them, because for me, you know, and then you just got to, like, love the eventual when they lose their shit.
Oh.
During the interactions.
Okay.
And so it was fun. They are adorable. Yeah, it's just Uncle Jimmy is not a full-time gig.
So it says Uncle Jimmy is 2 minutes, all right?
Says 2 minutes. I would say if you combined everything.
No, I think, no, but it's got to be consecutive. It can't be like 2 minutes here, 5 minutes here. It can't be like your Viagra bit, little bit each day. It's got to be consecutive.
Okay, hour in the morning, afternoon, and at night.
Okay, so what I'm thinking is consecutive time, I think you have it in you to make it 12 hours straight, yeah. Like one day.
Right.
And next day, you might wake up chipper, and then it's like, had enough.
It could be that way. These kids are smarter than Uncle Jimmy, so they don't buy Uncle Jimmy's threats. Yeah, they weren't phased.
Well, see, that's what happens. The threat needs to turn out of a threat into an action.
Yeah, I can't do the action.
No, you can't.
Not these days.
Because you'd go to jail or something.
Mm-hmm.
See, and that's some of it.
That's for real.
I saw a deal. Oh my God! I wish I would have saved it. These two moms did a thing about all the different, how the moms were different in the '60s through the 2010s. And I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
It talked about what they did then. Like, you could, in the 60s, you didn't only parent your own kids.
Parent the others.
You parented the others.
Yeah.
So you were the mom on the street. Didn't matter who it was.
Basically, the oldest was the in charge. Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So, you know, if you're running down the street, and, like, you know, we grew up, let's say I was down the street and your mom was there. My mom was at home. We're like four or five blocks away, right?
Right.
And I did something wrong. There'd be nothing wrong with your mom coming out and saying, "Hey, you knock that shit off or I'm beat your ass."
Oh, for real.
And it's like, and my mom would say, "Thank you."
Yeah.
Take care of that shit.
Yeah. You want me to tell your dad what you're doing out here? No. God, no.
And then you fix it right away.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But it was even a stronger statement when your parents' friends told you in a parenting way.
Right.
Because there was being bad.
That was respect
because
that you're going to be in trouble.
Outsiders loved you. Oh, look at little Jimmy just growing. Look at Paul. Look at Donnie. Oh, you guys, this is so great. But then when you were bad, they had no problem going, "Hey, I don't think your dad appreciate what you're doing right now. You're disrespecting him."
Oh, yeah.
When you get that, the verbal scolding.
Oh, yeah.
It was like, I really messed up.
I mean, my dad probably only a few times, you know, reared up and hit me. One of them, when it's cold, I still feel it. It hurt me a little bit in the chest right now. You know, it's probably 12 or 13. So I still feel it.
You feel it binding up?
I'm okay. You know, he hit me. It was pretty hard, and it still hurts a little bit, I got to tell you. But that never hurt me as much as when Dad was either upset or just pissed off, or I disappointed him.
Oh, yeah.
That was even worse.
Those were like head-hanging shame.
Because if one of those happens, if you did get an ass-whooping, it was over.
Right.
It wasn't a grudge. Okay, it's over. You got took your medicine. Have a nice day.
Right.
But if they were upset with you or you let them down.
If they said they were disappointed.
Ooh.
That was the worst.
Broke.
That was like, just spank me.
Yeah, just beat me.
Don't talk to me like
just
that.
Just beat me.
Don't talk to me like that.
Now, my mom, on the other hand, she didn't have a problem beating my ass.
Oh, they were the hand slappers. And my mom and dad. Dad was the heavy when I was little. And okay. All he needed was the voice.
Right.
Obviously. And the size.
Right. Well,
but then as we transitioned into teens, Dad was like, I get what you guys are good. I get what you're doing. Okay. I'm cool. I'll let you know.
Right.
But Mom ended up taking over. You know, the baton was passed over there. I remember she was slapping my brother on the back on the shoulder and yelling at Dad, "Will you control these kids?" But she was the one who needed control. We're like, man, she is losing it. Because she wouldn't hurt us, but it was like, man, she just lost her shit right here.
What would you two nerds possibly do to disappoint your parents? Oh, Lord.
Well, we don't have to get into it.
Oh, Lord. Hey, don't.
As my brother Paul says, why you got to bring up bad shit?
Yeah. I was so afraid of my dad, I held a lie for 30 years.
You held a lie?
Yeah, you know about it. And then I told him. My sister brought it up like four years ago and says, oh, my God, you know what happened? I'm like, yeah. And I felt like I was like
that was the
12
key.
Again. Yeah.
The key.
I felt like I was 12 years old again. I told my dad, and he looked at me, and I felt 12 again. Like
It just happened.
It hurt my heart.
Yes.
Hurt it.
I told you like 5 years ago at Christmas time, my daddy's got his chair. He's got his magazine rack on the side.
Right.
Coffee table, ottoman, dad's area. Mm-hmm. You can sit on it, but you're always looking over your shoulder.
Right.
Now, here he comes. I don't even want to be here when he gets here.
Right.
Well, we're doing the Christmas thing. It's a joyous occasion. I walk by, and I'm the present passer-outer.
Okay.
That's my job. And right. I've been tossing it back to Zach, my nephew.
Right.
So I gotta do a baton thing at the same time. Here we go. So I come through, I got presents, and my foot hits the rack and they fanned out. Boom.
Uh oh.
And I'm like, oh. No big deal. Like I'm at home. Oh shit. So I bend down and I'm next to my desk chair and I'm putting the magazine rack in there. I just felt my head moving away from my dad.
Yes.
Because I'm like getting out of the reach of the swing.
Right.
Going, yeah, but I wasn't even thinking about it. I wasn't saying, oh God, he's going to beat my ass because I'm this big. I just psychologically going, slowly going away. The voice was going over here. And I was like, here. And then my mom, what are you doing?
Nothing.
And Donna goes, he's getting out of the way to get his ass kicked. Bingo.
That's what happens. Yeah, I was afraid.
Evan, I was friends with the belt.
that sucked.
Oh, yeah. I think my behavioral stopped. I think it was mid-teens when my dad didn't whoop me, didn't anything. Like he just said that, he goes, you can do whatever you want. He says, but you made my wife cry.
Uh-oh.
He goes, now it's personal. I'm like, oh, he didn't even say mom.
Said my wife.
He did possession on that shit, and I was like, all right, we're good. All right.
All right.
These two little hairs on my chest mean business. All right, we gotta write this up. We gotta straighten up.
You know, I remember I started wrestling, you know, in high school. So I'd practice at home and we'd wrestle and Dad would wrestle with me.
Right.
And once in a while I felt like Dad is a little aggressive.
You gotta learn somewhere.
Like you know, and I was bigger.
Right.
You know.
Sure.
A little stronger.
Yeah.
But I could tell Dad was a little aggressive, like this is for all the times you pissed me off. Mm-hmm. I'm going to really give you a little tweak right here.
Just a little tap, a little something.
Yeah.
I'll give you a 9 count. I won't give you a 10.
Yeah. And
but
I'm like,
take you down.
And I thought, he took that a little too to heart.
Well, when my dad gave me his wife speech, he was actually looking up at me.
Sure.
I already had grown that far. So there, he's down here. He's a little dude now, but he'll take me out.
That's me.
Anytime.
I mean, you know me and my dad, same kind of thing. Yeah. I'm way bigger, stronger than my dad and everything, but I got to tell you.
I got to sweep his knee, boom, break a knee, and he's done.
Scare the shit out of me still.
Yeah, no, I don't. Oh, my God.
Don't cross that thing. And that's what happens when your parents had the strength to beat you, you still had that respect.
Because they weren't doing it because they were drunk. They weren't doing it because they had issues. They're doing it because you needed to be human beings.
You need to be
right people.
Good people.
Yeah, be good people. Good citizens. That's what they used to tell us in school. Be a good citizen.
Yeah, that was a good one, huh?
Yeah.
Be good citizens.
Be a good citizen. That went out the door.
Yeah, we just...
That shit doesn't happen no more.
I mean, you don't hear that in school anymore.
No, they don't. Ooh, for being cold outside, it's.
I was starting to think I wasn't feeling well, but I think
thought a stroke was coming because it just.
I wasn't sure. I was a little lightheaded. I was not feeling quite right, and then I thought maybe something was going on here.
Getting a little clammy.
I guess we're not quite as old as we think. Otherwise, we'd still have a sweater on. Oh shit! I have a sweater on. Never mind.
Nice
53, man.
Nice little quarter zip going on.
Well, I was out, you know, doing some work business today.
Of course you were.
Putting my face in front of people.
Oh, here's the birthday thing, right? So I got in the mail today.
Oh, do it.
Like your new cards are inside. Do not bend. I'm like, oh, debit card or something like that. I'm like, well, this is a treat. You know, I didn't do that. And I got a couple things for my taxes, which is nice. I'm like, oh, that's awesome. And I got my official membership to AARP right there.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. They sent the card up. I haven't signed up yet, but you know what? I ain't afraid of this thing. If I'm going to get some deals on it.
Now, here's the thing. I didn't ever sign up.
Yeah.
Well, Dawn signed up and then signed me up, too. It was an extra $10. So we're both on it. And she goes, they're going to give you deals. Why not take it?
It's true.
But I just have a problem throwing that card out. Like I'm surprising anyone.
Well, you know, people are surprised on how old when I tell them I'm my age. So apparently I look younger than
I hear actually that too.
So I actually like doing that just because of the surprise factor. Because at work, they're still trying to guess my age. And when I tell them, they're just stunned. I'm like, okay, cool. So pop out a AARP, man. I want to wait a couple more years and get one of them sweet-ass condos up here in Foothill. I don't mind being in a community thing like that.
I wouldn't mind. There's
come clean my shit.
There's one in. We talked about a long time ago here on the show. There's one. I think it's called the Villages in Florida. They're their own city. It's like real houses, not condos.
Right.
They golf cart around where they have their own movie theater, shopping mall, all that stuff, and it's in their own deal.
I'm down.
But what cracks me up about there is they have the largest STD issue per capita in the United States.
Because it's inside these walls. It's contained right there.
Right. And what happens is, I guess they just don't worry about birth control because, you know, no one's going
to
pop an out of base.
No one's spawning.
So they're just throwing crank at everyone.
Sean, you remember how we explained that to you.
That's why
Erica, me too. Guess my age. Oh, God, no.
Come here to Chino. I'll guard you. Yikes.
Guess my age. A very spry 35. That's all I'm going to say. Don't kick my ass. Come to Chino and I'll guard you. What are you going to guard us for?
I don't know. I don't think I need to. I need to be guarded.
What are we talking about?
I think he's talking about the retirement community.
Oh, gotcha. Yes. Yeah, you've got the experience.
Yeah.
You would definitely be our guy.
Okay.
You'd be our heavy.
Yeah, I get it. You'd be the guy we'd go to. As a matter of fact, I'd probably hire you just for me.
Yes, senior condos. Got it.
Just to be my personal guard of bodiness.
Farnsworth with the umbrella. Can you see Dennis doing that?
Yeah.
Following you with holding an umbrella for you?
Wow, that was loud.
Yes!
I got a little too excited for you, Dennis. You know why? You know why?
Because?
Because it's just the love.
Oh, he tagged us somewhere. What are we doing? Having some delicious shrimp fried rice and dumplings along with some kimchi and watching/listening to Roy and Jimmy Thing on Chaotic Radio. That is our buddy Dennis Winslow. Dude, that fried rice shrimp looks so good.
What?
Oh, he tagged us. This is what he's eating right now, watching and listening to
it. Oh, I thought it was on Facebook. It was on the other
one. Dude, that is delicious looking.
Hey, better watch out for those chopsticks. If you were at Chino, you know what that meant. Yikes. Boy,
I had comedians.
Yeah, I had comedians talking about chopsticks, but whatever.
Yeah, choppies.
Yeah. We'll just say, never mind. So, we got a bunch of, since it's our birthday, we got some lists to do with our birthdays.
Yes, we have to. It's the law.
And we have our days, we have our countdowns, we have more banter. We got everything.
We got all that.
Let's get out here and cool off a little bit, man. I'm like way hot.
Freaking burning up.
Yeah.
Burning up.
We're always crying that it's too hot in here. And now it's too hot.
Yes.
Oh, I guess it's the same.
Yeah, absolutely. It's the same feeling.
All right, we're going to get out of here. Don't give us a call because obviously they're not working. But hey, if you message us, we'll tell you a phone number you can call. We'll put you on the air. We can do that.
We can.
All right. We'll see you in a minute. Welcome back to the Roy and Jimmy Thing here on chaoticradio.com. Listen in, hit the chat room, go into the YouTube, find the chat there, find something. We're talking to people.
That's us. Roy and Jimmy Thing.
That's us.
Look home of chaoticradio.com. What?
That's backwards.
we got top billing on that, though.
Oh, okay. We lost our jacket and sweater.
It's like a sauna in here.
Yeah, whew.
Like a sauna.
Yeah, I was like too hot. I'm gonna see if this works. Let's see.
We're like losing weight.
I could use it. I gotta see which one's mine. That's not it.
Nothing a mom can do right, and there's a million ways to do it, but we don't know which one to pick.
Okay. Let's just reverse. We're gonna go break it down to what was to what's now. See, the 50s moms, they didn't have to worry about every time they left something out of the house that was considered dangerous.
There was no kid-proofing back then. You know what they got their kids to do? To use their common sense.
Oh, right? What's that? You didn't need any special attachment to prevent the kids from turning on the oven because they knew the oven was hot and it would burn them.
If you needed something from the store, guess who you could send for it?
Your kids. Mm-hmm. And guess what? They came home. They also knew not to put their fingers into electrical sockets. Somehow, those children figured out that what happened.
True.
Where did that common sense go?
Yeah.
Common sense. Moms, 60s moms.
They were allowed to not only discipline their own children, they were also allowed to discipline that child who was running amok out on the street.
It was as mentioned,
that
yes.
You would help take care of all of the children, not just your own, because they actually played out in the community. Do you know what a community is? Johnny might be gone for 3 hours, but you know what? You knew that the other people had Johnny's back.
Yep.
You weren't concerned about it. There were no red flares going off if you hadn't seen your kid in 2 minutes.
Then there was the 70s mom.
Girl, you coming over for a cocktail at 3 o'clock? The 70s moms consider getting together, not for judgment purposes, but for fun.
Nobody was judging how many martinis you had.
And when your children brought home Popeye cigarettes, you weren't concerned about whether or not it was going to cause long-term damage.
And in the playgrounds, they were made with that death trap hot metal.
Yeah, and I bet with concrete on the bottom. You know, the 80s.
Right?
Yeah, there was no more
French cooking and casseroles. Now is prepared foods.
Food that expired in like 20 years.
Perfect.
Feed the kids and move on.
Hamburger Helper, it's got carbs, it's got protein, and I'm sure that it's got some tomato sauce, which is like vegetable.
You know those older kids you have in your house?
They were free babysitters.
It was an expectation that they actually helped.
They ate their sandwiches back then. You know why? Because they were on white bread.
90s moms, yo.
You had a cool mom when everybody in the cafeteria was looking over at your lunch because you had all the goody-goody-goody-goys.
It was not taken away from you at that when you were in the 90s. It was like, oh.
I actually used to think the kids with those lunches, I'll be honest, I thought they were rich.
Do I have to make?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's the 2000 moms now. You know what? Shit, why'd we make it so hard on ourselves? What the f*** happened? What is organic couscous? What is non-organic couscous? What the f*** is coconut oil?
What the f*** is ghee?
Girl!
It's called butter.
It's called butter.
Everyone just united.
And moms
like,
today.
Dude, let's
we're
quit stopping.
It.
Let's
quit
open the doors back up. Let's talk to each other like people. Sit on the front step with a glass of wine and not look at each other and judge each other like there's some big deal going on. I'm not sure why moms need to get all kook-a-doodle-doo all of a sudden. Never has there been such high expectations on moms. Never has there been so much judgment on moms. And never have we felt so anxious and unconfident in ourselves as moms. We all just going back it.
We're going back it up. Relax. Just relax a little bit.
Happy Mom Truth Friday.
Back it up.
But think about it. As we grew, that was how we came through.
My sister was our babysitter, and she's only one more year older than I.
Right.
And one time, we're all going out to dinner, and she acted up. She stayed home. Dad left her at home.
Right.
So you're not coming with. We'll be back later.
Peace. Done.
Peace.
Have a nice day.
Yeah.
Or don't.
Or don't. We prefer if you didn't.
Right.
Yeah.
I told the story about my dad leaving me out on the street at 10:30, 11 o'clock at night in the middle of the neighborhood because I was acting up in the car. I said, get out. Walk. We're not home yet. Get out. I told you. Get out.
Don't make me pull this car over.
And he pulled it over and kicked us both out of the car.
Out you go.
And then my sister whined and got back in, but not me. I'm like 10 years old at 11 o'clock at night about walking home by myself. And we lived on the other side of it. I had to walk by a cemetery to get home.
Oh, Ontario. Yeah.
Didn't care.
Made you stronger.
It made me something. Scared the hell out of me.
Made you the man you are now.
No, because I'm still scared. No, I'm not. I'm a man. But, I mean, that's...
I was just outside by myself.
I mean, that's just... It wasn't the threat that this is going to happen. I'm going to threaten you. No, it happened.
It was a follow-through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was the thing, is when you have the threat and it doesn't get followed through on, you know it's like, they're just full of shit.
Oh, and they can sense that. They already know. Yeah, they already know it's not happening.
Right. It's not... And just on parents and the way kids are today, kids are a little more aware today than they were in the past. And this is a short clip that I just had to play just because it made me laugh.
Go ahead.
Uh-oh. What happened?
What'd you do?
Oh, I turned it down. Kids are playing video games.
What? I have a picture to show you. I don't know if you can see anything in there. Can you see anything in there? That's my belly, but...
You're having a baby. You're having another baby? When did you guys have sex?
That's hilarious.
When did you guys have sex? Oh my god, that just cracked me up. Can you imagine you're doing that thing? That's not what you're expecting the kid to say, but
that's awesome.
That's actually funny.
Ariana here, she says Uncle Jimmy loved making the niece sit at the dinner table until she finished her dinner. I did. And fair enough, she eats so slow, but she wouldn't finish that last chew.
Yeah,
the dessert chew. And we're all waiting for her. We're all sitting at the table. Finally, I got up. I cleared the table except for her. Everyone wanted to stay with her, not me. Sit down. Yep. Shush. Shush. Quit your crying.
Quit your crying.
Quit your crying. Yes, she ended up crying. And I said, hey, quit your crying. Swallow your food. Done.
Done.
There. How hard was that?
Now, if dinner was ready and it was time to eat and you decided you didn't want it, did you get something else or that was it?
No, that was it. In fact, you saw my post.
Which was that?
Ariana asked him, says, you want some cereal with your sister? Oh, yeah. He said, what else you got? I said, lunch.
Yeah.
Later.
Yeah, that's it.
Why? Here's the thing.
Here we go.
Here's the thing. And like I said, it's just my time and my upbringing, but you didn't ask questions.
No, there wasn't a...
You didn't answer questions.
There wasn't either. There wasn't a conversation.
It wasn't a conversation. No. It wasn't a questionnaire.
Right.
Dinner's ready. What are we having? Dinner. Is what we're having. That's what you're having.
And God help us if it was a liver night.
Yeah. You can't say quit crying, I'll give you something to cry about these days because you'll have something to cry about in prison. Yeah.
True.
This is true. Yeah, I was tempted, Dennis, to cliche that one up, but there was a few of my dad's gems from the past that came through. And I sat at the table with my hand in my head just going, oh, my God. Oh my God! Oh my God!
And I don't think I was as more like dad, but I mean, there's more of that in there than there
but
is.
The gems I was whipping out was the one was look with your eyes and not your mouth.
Okay.
Yeah, that one.
I get it.
That one is weird. You just look with your, and then at one point I said to both of them, I had a meeting.
Oh,
I had to have a meeting.
Okay.
So we're having a meeting now, kids.
Stop.
So this is my house.
We had a meeting.
You don't touch everything, and you have to listen to the adults. We know more. Just quit asking so many questions.
You know my favorite part of that was?
What? Just shush. You don't always have to talk. You don't always have to talk. We're the adults. You're going to have to eventually listen to us. Whether it's this week at my house or down the road.
I get it.
Yeah, it was, my frustration level was quite high.
So
maybe... That was my ninth birthday. Yeah, my ninth birthday was wet spinach.
So maybe the 2 minutes was more correct than I thought it was. Maybe 12 hours was pushing a little far.
Well, it just depends. If you're listening to me, it's going to be a great time for you. And me.
I'm not going to be tough either. It's just the way it's going to be.
But my ninth birthday, Ariana mentioned that one, is for some reason my parents served the worst food I totally hate was wet spinach. Hmm. Out of the can?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't like spinach now where you cook it up.
Oh, it's leafy and shit. Yeah. And yeah, no, this is wet. And I told it I can't eat it. And that was on my birthday. My dad said, well, you're going to finish your dinner or you're not going to get any birthday cake. I didn't have birthday cake that year.
No?
No. I couldn't do it.
She had to blow the candles out?
My mom's pleading with me, for the love of God, just eat it. Just like me a few days ago.
Right.
I can't. And they held their ground, and that was the rules. I went to bed without cake.
On your birthday?
On my birthday.
And you know what? Today,
and I was,
you lived through it.
I was proud of myself.
Right.
I held my ground.
Right.
I was mad at them, but then it's like, well, they held the rules.
Right.
They then... If I have a flashback or a thing about it, is why would you give me that shit on my birthday?
Right. You knew it wasn't.
I understand that we didn't have a lot of money and vegetables, you have to eat them, but on my birthday.
You know what my mom's favorite vegetable was?
Huh.
That can of, that had carrots, peas, corn, and everything in it.
Oh, the mix, yeah.
Yeah, that mix, that was the go-to.
Yeah, because everything was in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we all had that, sure.
Yeah, that was it.
Yeah.
There wasn't enough butter in the planet. To make it
if you could just pour it like milk.
I'm going to have some vegetable soup with butter. But again, I mean, it's obvious I didn't starve.
Obviously. And neither did I. We made it through. I remember that we did have a liver and onion night.
Oh, yeah.
And it was a family across the board vote that's never happening again.
Right.
Because, it had to be frugal. And it's like, well, people do eat it. So we all... Dad all the way down. This shit ain't happening again.
Well, see, that's the deal. His dad was on board with it.
Yeah.
So that was dad's meeting.
Right.
That was so dad's meeting. So dad's going to have a meeting.
A declaration.
And it was okay.
A creed, if you will. Hear ye, hear ye.
But if dad had liked the liver and onions.
We all would have been screwed.
You'd still been eating it.
Yeah. Yeah. Hear ye, hear ye. On this day forth, the Shaw family shall not pass lips to liver and onions.
You're lucky that dad didn't like it.
Yeah.
Should have added some mayonnaise into that vegetable mix, Roy. Mayonnaise in anything. Now, here's the thing.
Makes Jimmy it all
was,
better.
Jimmy was just talking about the spinach. My mom used to put mayonnaise in the spinach.
Oh, God, I'm going to throw up. With the wet spinach? So gross.
I used to eat it.
That didn't even mix. It's like oil and water.
It's good.
Gross. So gross.
But this is the same one who used to fake me out with the cottage cheese and the lasagna.
Ah. That's true. That's true, yeah.
I thought it was ricotta.
You thought you were ricotting that shit up.
Although I got to tell you, a couple people we talked about it said that that's the way people made it.
True. This is true.
So, I mean, it's okay. Maybe that was maybe that's where my mayonnaise disorder came from.
Oh, so disorder, good. That was a good way of putting it. That's kind of gross.
Evan just says I'm going to puke.
Right, Evan? Oh, my God. Wet spinach and mayonnaise. Oh, my God.
So good.
Oh, God.
Well, it's saved on butter because mayonnaise is cheaper than butter.
Oh, boy. So gross. And there was no fashion underwear. Your tidy whities were freaking streaked out with shit like that. It was all white underwear, too.
Hey, that's one move that I think was good when they started coloring them up.
Oh, I think so.
You know.
I think so.
You know, it's like, hey, look, to this day, I'm like... Pfft.
I mean, I try to keep myself sanitary as possible,
sure.
But I don't want to see the evidence neither at the end of the day going, you mean this was all day? How long was this happening?
Well, and today, I'm a fan of the wipes in the bathroom.
Oh, okay.
Do you have those?
No.
You ever had those?
No.
Well, there was a little container.
I mean, not for that purpose.
When we in the crapper.
Uh-huh.
There's a little thing there for these little wipes that are supposed to be in there, and I'm like, let's get some. I like them.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we don't have any right now. I still don't have an issue, but I liked them.
Well,
when you walk out of there, you do the first clean through, and then you wipe her up with that thing in there. You just feel so fresh all day.
Without going in detail, I'd rather have that as an off location option.
Well, I'm gonna tell you,
which I don't do.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, it's not. It's not unusual. It wouldn't be unusual for me to have a cup in my pocket when I'm out Ubering.
Well,
I gotta go
if you're because you would be out a lot. I'm only buying white undies, so I know they're clean. that's your discipline, self-discipline. Like you want to pop a fart out, you're like, wait a minute, I got the whites on. I don't want to find out that I've been holding this shit back for like 5 hours. Even that face of yours.
I got something come through on the text. I can tell what it was.
No, but like I said, I don't off location squat, but when I do, then I would say the wipes would be at home. Please, if it's that bad, I'm popping in the shower. If my unsureness exceeds the confidence level,
if it goes too much,
yeah, then I'll pop in the shower.
Yeah,
yeah. We went from mayonnaise to taking a shit, which was probably what happened to you.
From mayonnaise to the other. Well, I mean, the Dollar Shave Club has, they actually.
That's right. The One Wipe Charlie's.
One Wipe Charlie's.
That's right. I heard a Bill Burr
talking
about
those are that. Bigger ones. Those that clean up some business.
When people say I use too much toilet paper, I say I use as much as I need. There's no sense. Yeah, it looks like an of glove.
Well, here's
when women
the thing,
use it. But here, it looks like a catcher's mitt.
I get it. I get there's not a problem with using it, but here's the deal. There's a part where it's un. What am I looking for? God, I'm looking for the word. It's un. Know. Not economical is not the word. If you get too much, it's not going to help.
Okay.
Like if you use a whole roll, it's not going to help. And if you used
you're defeating the purpose.
Yeah. There's too much. Gotcha. So there's a lot not used.
You might as well just get a towel and
right.
Do the old after the shower little pat down.
Right. So it's uneconomical. It's overkill.
It's overkill. Yeah, right. Absolutely.
I mean, you need to have more than one sheet.
But if women make it look like a catcher's mitt, and for a
right
for a little a pat,
little
it's like a bringer in at the bottom of the ninth. Bring in the righty.
Get it. God, this thing went to hell real quick. started at the mayonnaise and
with the mayonnaise and the wet spinach. Evan, you know this. You know what exactly happened right there.
Oh my God. It's
it's what?
You know what? This thing I gotta look at it now because I read this wrong. I thought it was insomnia, but it's not.
You know what I need to do?
Go ahead.
And this is for the listeners, is our website's going under construction. As you can tell, go to chaoticradio.com and look at this beautiful, up-to-date thing going on that's still evolving.
Yeah, it by the day.
By the day. Almost by the hour.
Mm-hmm.
However, during this transition, I'm unable to post to iTunes.
Okay, but they're all going to come at some point.
They are going to come. But So I probably need to do like we used to do at the locker room.
Mm-hmm.
Last week on the Roy and Jimmy thing.
Yes.
For the recap, because we had Shaquille O'Neal.
Yeah.
We had the beef.
Shaquille's in there.
Beef.
Yeah.
Skidmark underwear.
You used to do that. Remember when we used to go to breaks and I'd say, recap what we did this half hour?
That's true. Yeah, that's true.
Maybe we should bring that back.
We're going to have to, but I'm going to have to do it weekly basis because we can't go to last week's episode.
Okay.
And I don't want people to go, well, Dennis is like the biggest guy. He stays on top. He keeps us right. You know? We're the last three damn episodes.
Right.
I'm trying to catch up here.
It's hot in here. I got my sweater off. You got your jacket off, and it's still getting hot in here.
I'm with Ariana. No such thing as too much, but more than three tries in his shower time. So basically, Don, what you're saying is after half a roll, then you both decide, hey, you know, maybe I should just pop in.
Yeah, but then he had the one wipe Charlie's. You're good to go. Clean that up. The only thing is, here's the deal. I do the first, if you got the Charlie thing going on, you do the first swipe, get her all cleaned up, maybe two. Get her all cleaned up. Then you go through the equivalent or one wipe Charlie.
Right.
And then at the end, I got to run a dry streak. I got to run like the chamois through it.
Well, yeah, because you don't want to be, oh God, so gross. Yeah, but I know what you're talking about. You don't want your crack moist sealing it up.
Right. Right.
So gross.
But it's true.
Send all your complaints to Dutchie@chaoticradio.com.
So it's just like if you wash your car.
Yeah, exactly.
So you wash your car, you get it all nice. You gotta run the chamois over, get it dried up.
You got the quick wipe to get the surface and then the chamois for the sheen.
You're right. Ari's right. It is a dry, wet, dry sequence.
Yes.
Recap: children discipline, shitting pants, Roy's mayo addiction, Evan stocking up on kudos cards.
And that's the show. We're wrapped up right
now. Wrapped up. All right. We were going to go to 10, but Dino 5, out of here.
Evan's keeping us right on track there. Yes. Yeah, so there's our recap.
This one, I thought it was Insomnia Awareness Day on the 27th.
Okay.
But it's Anosomnia.
Anosomnia.
Yeah. Which is...
Anosmia?
Anosmia, maybe.
Okay.
Which is to the awareness to increase the limited information available about anosmia, I guess. The loss of sense of smell, which goes right into our conversation into that we have right now.
Our wet wipes, and for the women, if it takes more than half a roll of toilet paper, pop it in the shower.
So it affects over 6 million Americans.
So you lose your smell.
Smell. So I can see, now that I'm always wondering about, say a guy or a girl really has a little funky smell about him, like a pit smell or whatever it is.
Sure.
And then you're like, how does the person that they're dating or married to not, how do they live with it? Well, maybe they have that.
Oh, I got you. The trade-off.
Right. So they're like, wouldn't you, I don't smell it.
So there's two afflictions in this family.
Right. One stinks and one can't smell it.
Gotcha.
So there you go. So there's something for everyone. Just like in the car business, there's an ad for every seat.
Gotcha. Now, if you're doing a list of things, I think tomorrow is going to be one of my favorite days.
Mm. It may be. I'm going to go back to it. Today is National Pancake Day.
Didn't we have one?
No, it's today.
I thought there was one last week.
International Polar Bear Day is today.
Well, they're not international. I think they're defined to one region.
Is tomorrow... Maybe I don't think you're looking for Pink Shirt Day tomorrow.
No, but I am. I'm not afraid to do it.
Okay. Inconvenience Yourself Day?
That's every day.
Okay, that's tomorrow, officially.
I'm inconvenienced every
day. It's always the fourth Wednesday. Tomorrow is National Tooth Fairy Day.
That's not the one, but that's okay. So what, everyone knock your teeth out tonight? How do you celebrate? Let me see. National Tooth Fairy
Day.
Day. Now,
well, I have some information on some Tooth Fairy.
Do it. I want to see how you celebrate this.
Well, no, not about celebrating, but there's some bad news for the Tooth Fairy, for the kids these days. Really bad news.
Go.
From 2017 to 2018,
mm-hmm.
Last year the average left for a kid was $4.66 in 2017 for a Tooth Fairy.
How'd it get to be change like
Well, that? It's an average.
Okay.
So still. One might leave a 7, one might like 3, but it's an average.
Oh, gotcha.
Right.
Okay.
Okay. The average this year?
Yes.
$4.13 a tooth. So it's a 50-cent drop in Tooth Fairy charges.
Well, maybe these smart little bastards should get a Venmo account.
Tooth Fairy's getting tired.
Yeah. So you, what else do you want me to do for you? Send me your PayPal.
So right now, I mean, Tooth Fairy... The money's not as good as it used to be.
No, we don't care. You already have everything you need.
Wow!
Why should I dig deep into the pockets for cash no one has?
Okay. All right. So that I do have a couple lists this week, yes. But that brings me to the next question, or the next bit of information, not question.
On what?
Well, I mean, since we were both born in the year 1965.
1965. Yes, sir.
Yes. What do you think the rate for a tooth fairy to pay for a tooth was in 1965?
Well, like a 50 cents, a dollar? Quarter? I mean, it wasn't a lot. When I lost some of my baby teeth in the 70s, I remember it being a freaking windfall.
$1.24.
That's the average.
That was the average.
I think it was like a quarter. 50 cents, maybe?
So you're bringing the average down in a Shaw household.
Why would they give me that kind of money they didn't have?
Right, I'm just saying.
I'm going to burn the house down. I'm going to have a little temper tantrum at Kmart.
$1.24. And it's funny because it was $1.26 in 64, dropped 2 cents to $1.24 in 65, dropped again $1.21 in 1966.
Yeah.
67 went to $1.17. 68 went to $1.12.
Yeah, there's Evan, 50 cents. I mean, that seemed, yeah, quarter, 50 cents.
But look how it dropped. 69 went to $1.06. 70 was $1.01. 71 dropped under $1 to 96 cents.
As it should have been. You just lost a tooth. Who cares?
72 went to 93 cents. 73 went to 88. 74, 79 cents, 75, 73 cents. It dropped all the way to 60 cents in 78. We're even lower. 1982 was 40 cents.
Good.
83 was 40 cents. But where it's all the way down to 26 cents in 95.
Good. Here's a quarter. Here's something for the effort.
Just telling you, man.
Yeah. No, Evan's 50 cents a quarter. It's not, now it's $5. And everyone, it's like allowance.
I'm telling you, it's kind of as go the tooth fairy rates, go the economy. So we need to throw all the economists out the thing. We just find out what people are paying for teeth.
Yes.
And then we'll know what's going on. That's all we do.
Yeah, spoiled bastards.
No? Okay.
No, I like the theory.
Like the theory.
It's going to take a long time to see if it's true, but yeah, we can get on board now.
It's kind of funny we're talking about spinach and mayonnaise because it's actually National Eating Disorders Awareness Week.
Ariana, this is what. There's my point. Her nephew lost one just yesterday. He got $7. She used to get $10. Jesus.
What, Christ. $10 a tooth?
Oh, my God.
Holy smoke.
Jesus.
Ballers.
I'm going to start sending some hate mail to some parents now.
Should we get a gold bar?
Jesus.
Man. What day did you have yesterday that you were excited about?
I thought it was for tomorrow, one of your national days.
Which one?
Let me make sure.
Because I didn't see it. I
ran across it just by.
So it was on the 20th. It was on, tomorrow's the 28th. I'm going to look on my list here to see if I can pull something else on 28th that I may have missed. In error. Let me. You know what? I'm going to look.
Here it is. I think.
Is it the 28th?
Hang on, buddy. Let me. I ran across. I thought for sure it'd be on your.
No, I don't see. I don't see anything else on 28th that looks like it makes any sense. 29th.
Well,
not there?
No, I'm way off. I'm like 5 months off.
Oh, never mind then.
Okay, never mind. Okay. I thought it was something right up my alley, too.
Well, in 5 months from now, we'll be right in there.
Yeah.
Evan,
lucky if I got five a tooth.
Five a tooth? Baller?
That's grandma and the birthday card money right there, Evan.
Yes. It's National Justice for Animals Week. Should be every week. Animals need justice.
See, now you sound like me.
What?
Should be every week.
Should be, because animals.
See? Starts working at you. Starts getting it under your skin.
I think, right. But that's one, I mean, justice for animals.
See, you got that bitter of the tooth fairy coming right through into that one. That's perfect. I got to set you up with one that pisses you off, too.
Okay.
Takes you down the road and be honest about
I hear you.
Shit and be honest with yourself.
I am. Because, you know, justice for animals, I'm thinking like people beating animals.
What
and
do
stuff.
We do for those days? See, here's the thing. You have these stupid days. What are you supposed to do? Let's see here. National Justice for Animals. I'm going to look it up. What do you want me to do?
You had to pay for Hot Wheels somehow. I'm really into grease. What's that? Gas Monkey Garage lately.
That guy's such a douche.
I know, but I just can't stop watching it.
Yeah, if he took the time he does on his facial hair on his cars,
but he didn't have to. He's got that other.
Such
dude.
A freaking douche.
It's a badass.
Such a douche.
I like him.
Let's see here.
I like
get involved. National Justice for Animals Week. Right. All right, what are we gonna do here? What do you want me to do? What am I supposed to do here?
Smack around some people that jack up some dogs.
It's a yearly event dedicated to raising public awareness nationwide about the criminal animal abuse, including how to report it, how to work with your community to create stronger laws and ensure tough enforcement. Well, that's already there. So you just rat people off if they're treating their animals like shit. I'll make it this bandstanding. I support it. What color ribbon is that, huh? What do we? I got a. Is there a Facebook profile picture template I got to put up now with that ribbon on?
Wow, I thought it was a good thing to take care of.
It
dogs.
Is a good thing, but you don't have to tell me that I have to do it this week.
Oh, I get it. It should be. And, like I said, it should be every week.
Right, but I don't even have to. Like, you know, I helped an old lady across the street today. Anybody? Nothing? Is there a day for that?
Okay, I feel you.
Should I do it next week?
I feel you. I do feel you, Jimmy.
Stupid. Anyways.
It's National Patsy Week.
Patsy Week, really? Like the Patsy I think that would be? Like you pawn something off on somebody? Or is it a dog thing?
No, it's stupid.
Let me see. Patsy.
Hot Patsy Mania.
What the fuck is that? Hot Patsy? I don't like how that's going. I got nothing coming up here. I've got Patsy Cline on the NPR.
Okay. Hot Patsy Mania is gripping London today as the food Cornwall gave to the world takes over the capital. giant couple, Mr. and Mrs. Patsy, led a team from the far southwest in a Patsy Week. It must be some kind of food in over there. And we can ask Dutchie about it.
It's their name. It's not the Patsy, like, you know.
It's a Cornish Patsy Week.
You know, like you go to a bank robbery and the Patsy is the guy you leave behind. Right?
Now, now that's what I'm thinking. But these Patsies look like a mix between a calzone and a taco.
Shit we've never heard of, but I would eat that.
I would eat that.
I would totally eat that.
There they are. It looks like sight unseen. Like an empanada.
Oh yeah, that thing's gone. All three of those.
But I don't know what's in them, so got
to
be careful.
I still have to try it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cornish Patsy Week. What's in a patsy? It just says Cornish Patsy Week. Doesn't say what's in it.
All right. Let's look up.
I'm telling you what, they look delicious.
Cornish would be stuffing, right?
I'm thinking Cornish is like. There's a big one, right? These two guys are freaking arm wrestling for. It must be a big thing. What is about the Patsy? What is PGI? Make your own. Here we go. I found a make your own. Ooh, looks delicious. Oh, it's right up my alley. 500 grams of strong bread flour.
Strong.
120 grams of lard.
Mayo.
125 grams of Cornish butter. Tablespoon salt, cold water, and for the filling, it comes with a beef skirt, potatoes, swede, I don't know what that is, onion, and salt and pepper to taste, and a beaten egg. It's a meatloaf inside of bread.
Inside of a pastry. Yeah.
We got to do that
and
here.
Three of those ingredients you can knock out as mayo. Oh,
I can put mayo in it.
Yeah.
No. Mayo dipping sauce.
Mayo dipping sauce. Otherwise known as mayo. You fancied that up pretty good, though. Mayo dipping sauce, I like.
Well, I put a little something in it because I put a little ketchup in it, a little Tony's seasoning.
Right.
Mix it all up. Maybe a little shot of...
Give it the old secret sauce.
Oh, a little extra.
Give it the old secret sauce.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do. Okay.
It's Telecommuter Appreciation Week. That one ought to piss you off.
Fuck them.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, yeah. Sorry about the F word there. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, but yeah, fuck them.
It's sweet potato month.
That's a bad month for it.
But it's also in November, so they get 2 months on a sweet potato.
I was going to say, it should be November. Why are you going to give it to me February?
It's both. Wise Healthcare Consumer Month.
What? Wise Health?
Wise Healthcare Consumer Month.
Sure.
Worldwide Renaissance of the Heart Month.
What do you renaissance your heart with?
And Youth Leadership Month.
Oh, God.
I just had to get those.
How do you even spell Renaissance? Renaissance. Okay, what? Renaissance of the Heart?
Yeah.
All right, let's see. That sounds like a song or a play of the heart.
Total eclipse of the heart.
Worldwide Renaissance of the Heart Month. What do you want me to do? What are you expecting of me?
I don't know.
Let's see.
You got to do it all month. We only got 2 days left.
Internationally celebrated Renaissance of the Heart Month is in February because of Valentine's Day. That's my take on this. Dedicated compassionately thinking about with your heart as well as your intellect. Well, it's not about heart health. It's about heart thinking to me. That's what I'm picking up out of this.
Okay.
So, thinking with your heart as well as your intellect.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all right. You should do that every day.
Ready? What? It should be every day.
It should be every day.
All right. We got two lists.
So it's basically to remind people, hey, stupid, think with your heart, too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, and sorry, as the niece and nephew say, stupid's not really a good word to use for anything. I was reminded a couple times when we're driving. A stupid driver. No, stupid's mean. Yes, I agree. I had to curb my stupid back. A couple moments, man.
I gotta pull my stupid back.
All
right.
I had to pull my stupid back.
We're gonna go straight through you. We want to take a break and do our lists. What are you thinking?
Oh wow, I guess we can knock one out. I'm not even ready for that yet.
For what?
For a break.
Oh okay. Then do we want to do?
I can be though, because I am a pro.
Well, what you want to do?
I'm set us up with commercials. Do you have any countdowns to do right now?
I got like three. I don't know which one we'll do.
Do you have your usual?
Yeah, I've got that.
When's that coming?
Yeah.
Well, let's do that, and I can do the other.
It's always ready.
Oh, good. Good for you.
I'm always ready.
I know you are.
You know why?
My bad.
Because it's the something of the heart or something. Renaissance.
It's Renaissance. I know what that has to do with it. I wasn't going to dog it for heart health.
Right.
I had a hunch it wasn't.
Okay, good.
Because it didn't say heart
health. All right.
Because we have friends who have heart problems.
Right.
Heart problem is a serious thing.
Serious. It should
but
be every day.
But you throw that bullshit into it, think with your heart as well as your intelligence.
Got a problem.
Then it's like, no kidding.
Right.
Hashtag no shit.
Hashtag.
Why don't we just have every month hashtag no shit month, and then I'm covered.
Should be every day.
Yeah, exactly. It should be every day.
Be good people. Be good citizens.
Be a good citizen. What was that, Davy and Goliath and Highlighter magazine? Be a good citizen.
I don't know, Davy.
Davy, I don't think you should rape that chicken.
My favorite one was the when they were making fun of Davy not jumping, not going in the construction thing and jumping off the rails.
Yeah.
Davy Hanson's chicken. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Who said that?
You call me chicken.
Well, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now he just walks around with a neck tattoo. You call me chicken.
David, Davy's.
Call me chicken.
Oh my gosh!
All right, you're on. Did I hit it too soon?
No, I got it. Today, till 2019, it's 307 days, 7,370 hours. I'll save you some time. It's 442,238 minutes. Don't look at your calculators. I get this one too. 26,534,295 seconds. Until Tuesday, January 1st, 2019. This is what time? Los Angeles time, right?
LA time. Pacific time, yes.
Yeah. So it's 307 days, 2 hours, 38 minutes, and boop, 0 seconds at the beat.
Excellent.
See there? That's ready.
That was pro. Pro shit right there.
Bro. Post it up. Are you kidding me?
Pfft. Are you kidding me?
Bring me something.
Are you kidding me?
Bring me something tough. Just sounded like our dads right now. Huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
Really? Don't waste we my are time. Old.
All right. Let's
don't
get,
waste my time.
We got lists. Tell us in the chat room which list you want.
We have. You know, Roy's got this. He's got this.
Well, I've got singles of 65, movies or TV shows of 65.
I say we don't know.
Whew, we better hurry.
All
we'll
right.
Get out of here. We'll be right back in a minute.
You make me feel like...
Oh, that was beautiful.
What?
Yes.
You like that?
Yes, I did. That was nice. Well, Huey Lewis bringing us back into the Roy and Jimmy thing right here on chaoticradio.com, the home of the Roy and Jimmy thing. Your new and improved Tuesday nights.
Yeah.
Soon to be morning show.
Thank you.
Somewhere across great country of ours.
I just spit everywhere. When I said, thank you.
It slobbed up everything.
I saw,
Jesus Christ.
I saw it like it. It's like a sprinkler.
I was talking to the kids, Ava especially, the little niece. I'm talking to her. I was putting a ponytail in her Wonder Woman doll.
Good job, Uncle Jimmy.
Which is right up my alley.
Sure.
And I'm trying to explain to her why I can't do it after 3 tries. I did end up getting it. And she said, and right in the middle, because kids are on it, she goes, you spit on me. And I'll spit on you harder if you don't be quiet. Why I gotta bring up my faults?
We were playing... Night before we go to bed, we play a little crossword. Don plays on our iPad.
Right.
And I said a word, and I spit all over. You spit on
me.
You
did the old Sylvester. Fuffer and thuckatash.
I think the letter is B.
Spaghetti. Spaghetti.
Ah, boy.
Oh, boy.
Top list. We're going to blow through this one fast.
Is it list time?
Yeah.
All right. We love lists.
Top.
Hi, guys. Happy birthday week, boys. Is it National Cereal Day, Evan? Yes. Wednesday, March 7th.
I put her in there.
So that's next
week. Hey, what is up, Catherine? We only have a half hour, so we got to blow through.
Okay.
Most popular feature films released at 1165 to 1231 of 65.
What?
So in the year 65.
1965.
Yes, our birth year. Most popular feature films released.
Top 5.
Top 5? Let's go 10.
Well, you said we had to hurry up.
Let's go 10.
All right. Top 10.
Top 10.
This is the aging process.
Number 10.
Yes.
Cat Ballou.
James Coburn?
I think so.
Jane Fonda,
yes. Lee Marvin, Michael.
Lee Marvin.
Callen, Dwayne Hickman.
Men.
Yep.
Men talk like this.
Number 9.
Yes.
Battle of the Bulge.
That's a war movie, right?
Mm. Henry Fonda, Robert Shaw, Robert Ryan, Dana Andrews.
That's Men.
A dramatization of Nazi Germany's final Western Front counterattack of World War II.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Number 8. Repulsion. Never heard of it.
Never heard of that.
Catherine Deneuve.
Catherine Deneuve.
There it is.
Ooh. Oh, she was pretty hot.
Was she?
Too.
Oh.
Catherine Deneuve. Oh, yes.
I'm gonna open the link in the new tab just to see if I can get a picture. Oh.
Oh.
Well, this is her, like, old. She was looking good. Young, I bet. She's a gilf. Ian Hendry, John Fraser, Yvonne Furneaux.
Catherine, before my time. All of them.
A sex-repulsed woman who disapproves of her sister's boyfriend sinks into depression and horrific visions of rape and violence. Wow, sounds like a Lifetime movie. Number 7, The Great Race.
The Great Race.
Right.
Okay.
Grand adventurous race takes place between the heroic Leslie and the despicable Professor Fate across three continents. Tony Curtis, Natalie Wood, Jack Lemmon, Peter Falk.
Oh, that was a light little ditty there, little comedy slash adventure fantasy movie.
Got a seven on the thing. 5, Apache Blue.
Don't know it.
Sidney Poitier. Shelley Winters, Elizabeth Hartman, and Wallace Ford.
Sidney Poitier and Shelley Winters. Now, there's your blockbuster.
There's no business like show business. There's no business. That's Ethel Merman.
That's my impression of
that's Shelley. Ethel Merman. That's Ethel Merman.
Shelley Winters and the Poseidon Adventure is my impression.
Go.
There it is.
That was it. That was Apache Blue. It's a blind, uneducated girl is befriended by a black man who becomes determined to help her escape her...
Is she racist and doesn't know he's black?
...abusive home life, introducing her to the outside world.
Hmm. Yeah, and she's blind, so she doesn't realize he's a black man. It's a war rights movie-ish era, so it made it a nice feel-good movie. But if Sidney Poitier, it's got to be good.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, Ethel by Roy.
Nailed it! Number 4. For a Few Dollars More... There we go.
Clint Eastwood?
Clint.
Yes.
Lee Van Cleef, Gian Maria and Violante, and Mario Brega. 8.3 on a score. Two bounty hunters with the same intentions team up to track down a Western outlaw.
I know what you're thinking. Did I fire one bullet or two? I'm trying to put it to the air on that.
Yeah. Number 3, never heard of. How about if I give you the thing? A middle-aged iconoclast doggedly avoiding the tedium of employment and conventional life faces the prospect of losing custody of his young ward. Starring Jason Robards, Barbara Harris, Martin Balsam, Gene Sachs. 7.6. It's
just say the title.
1,000 Clowns. Never heard of it.
Wouldn't have been there at all.
Nope. Oh, the number 2 and number 1 have an 8.
All right, here we go.
Number 8, Omar Sharif, Julie Christie, Geraldine Chaplin, and Rod Steiger.
Yes.
Dr. Zhivago.
Oh, classic. Never seen it, but I've heard good things. I was a newborn. I didn't see it.
You're going to get this one. Number 1, it's a drama family. It's got Richard Hayden, Eleanor Parker, Christopher Plummer, and... The hills are alive with the sound. Yeah, Sound of Music.
The Sound of Music. Julie Andrews.
Julie Andrews.
Yes.
Number 1, 1965, in the year we were born.
That's three classics. That's the movie and Me and You. Coming out of that era.
So that was the movies.
Sure.
That was the movies. Wow, that one only took 6 minutes.
I know what you're thinking. Did they fire 4 bows and arrows? or three.
Maybe we should have just did a...
But you're going to ask yourself.
You know what? I'm going to run down the list to see if there's anything in there that was good that we missed.
Fire. Were they punk?
There's no... God, I missed it. I sound like Paul Lynn that time.
What? No Beatles movie on the list? Not in 65.
I think you had to go later.
Yeah, they were a little still Ed Sullivan-ishy.
Oh, here we go. 23, Those Magnificent Men and Their Flying Machines.
For the movies?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought we were done.
No, we were, but we only took 6 minutes on that.
Well, we got two more lists.
I know, but I was just looking through to see if anything else was
in
there.
You know me, I can embellish on anything. These lists.
There's no... There it is. Found it. There's no business. I'm going to run it into the ground. Let's go... We're going to end on music. We're going to go top-rated United States television programs in 1965. How many do you want to go? Oh, wow, this is a good list. We're going to go all the way down. We're going to go to 20... Wow. It's a tie for 23rd with 3.
I got to cue this up for you.
Okay. There it is. That's what I'm talking about.
You got to just... We need a line. It's your birthday. Go, Roy.
There's no business like show business. There's no business I know. Right? Appealing. I nailed it.
Oh, crushed Chilling. It. It jumped
Something
right in.
Take an extra pound.
It's your birthday. Go, Roy. That's awesome.
I can't believe I had that in me.
Dude.
I had no idea I had that in me.
You jumped in there, dude. That was awesome.
Man. Some talent right here.
Oh, that was beautiful.
So it's a tie. We'll go top 25 because it's pretty fast.
Go.
23 is a tie among three people. That's why it goes from 23 to 6.
TV shows. Go.
23, The Virginian.
Western, obviously.
The Wild Wild West.
That was a great show.
And The Jackie Gleason Show.
Okay. Variety show, Western now, and
Wild,
Adventure Show.
Wild Wild West, Jackie Gleason's show, CBS, and The Virginian, NBC. Like how I did that?
I like.
Okay. 22.
Yes.
Gilligan's Island, CBS.
Okay. Classics.
21.
Roy Singing just brought out a raccoon.
To the Junction, Petticoat Junction.
Petticoat Junction,
21. Number 19, that was CBS also. Number 19, I don't remember this, but now that I'm thinking about it, maybe I did. I've Got a Secret on CBS.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And number 19, Hawaii, isn't that what Lawrence Welk said?
Thank you, boys and girls. Another fun waltz from the Andrew sisters.
Thank you. That was it.
And a top of the hour, a 1, a 2, a 3.
You know that there is a Lawrence Welk. you look at me like that, buddy boy. There is a Lawrence Welk golf course.
Yes.
Down the 15.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Can you see him out there playing golf? Says,
and a 1, and a 2, and a 3, 4. Oh, I can't believe you did that. I work with Lawrence Welk's son. I was an extra on this thriller that they filmed in Bakersfield. You remember that, Jeffrey? Oh, Pat.
Same person.
Oh, I just nailed Jeff.
You nailed it.
Oh, Pat.
He nailed it.
I was just asking, can I ask a question, Pat? No, you can't ask a question. I do all the questions here.
Sound like Edith Brunkley. We may have to abandon these lists because we're going to do this one right now.
No, do it.
We're going to do this. Here.
Do it.
I'm going to be Archie. You're going to be Edith. And we're going to sing the All in the Family.
Oh, my favorite. God.
Because, yeah, you did sound like Edith right there.
Did I do a little Edith? Yeah. I had a little Edith in me?
Yeah. Yeah, she said you had it right there. All right.
I didn't know that.
Here we go. Let's see if we can see if we can
I didn't know Ethel and I didn't know they had the same. I didn't know they're the same person.
I wonder if I got the lyrics on this thing.
I think I can do the lyrics.
Here we go. I need them.
I don't know if I can. But if it's playing in the background, I can do it. Okay. You know, one of those karaoke things.
I told you that's going to be. Yeah. Yeah. All right, here we go. Yeah. All the Family theme song with lyrics. You're going to be Edith.
Boy, the way Glenn Miller played. songs that made the hit parade.
Guys like us, we had it made.
Those were the days. We knew who you were then.
Girls were girls and men were men.
Mr. We could use a man like Harvey Hoover again.
Didn't need no welfare state.
Everybody pulled his weight.
She our oldest salary and great.
Those were the days.
Right? I knew the words. It cracked me up. That makes me laugh.
Fucking okay, Roy as Edith Barker. That's beautiful. Beautiful. Go ahead, Ethel.
Oh, Archie.
Stifle it.
19. Ed Sullivan Show. You can do an Ed Sullivan.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a really big shoe for you tonight. Topo Gigio.
There you go. Also
ladies
ties for...
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beatles.
Sheila. Never mind. 17. The Walt Disney Wonderful World of Color.
Ooh, in color. In living color, yes. Right.
Number 16, in Dick Van Dyke Show.
In living color, you can be what you want.
Whatever.
To be.
Wrong one.
In living. Oh.
Wrong, Dick, whatever. 16, Dick Van Dyke Show.
Very good show.
13.
Yes.
My Three Sons.
Oh, with the feet. Yeah, with the feet.
Number 14, Daktari.
Daktari.
I didn't know what that was.
That's a word. Yes.
Was it?
Yes.
13, The Man from U.N.C.L.E.
Good show.
Number 12.
Starring.
Yeah.
The guy who plays Ducky on NCIS now.
Oh, really?
But he was the man from U.N.C.L.E.
Oh, okay. Number 12. Missed it by that much.
Get smart. Chief.
Number 11, Green Acres. Oh, we could do that song, too.
Green Acres is the place for right. me. Farm living is the life I see. I don't know the rest. Take Manhattan.
Land stretching out so far and wide.
Take Manhattan, just give me that countryside.
And then she goes,
New York is where I'd rather stay.
You are nailing
the... I get allergic smelling hay. I just adore a penthouse view. Darling, I love you, but give me Park Avenue.
You are crushing the female parts
okay.
tonight.
Okay. Number 10, Batman.
Ah, I love Batman.
Number 9, I used to like this too. Hogan's Heroes.
It was funny. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, it was funny.
Yeah.
Schultz!
Not, such stupid
Schultz!
Asses.
Schultz!
Didn't Robert Crane kill himself or something?
No, he got murdered doing some kind of porn thing.
Oops.
Yeah. No, Daktari was about out in the jungle with lions and shit. Thanks, Dennis.
Thanks, I appreciate it,
I didn't see
Dennis.
That definition in the TV guide about the lions
sorry,
and
sorry,
shit.
Sorry, man.
I was a newborn.
Don's like, perfect. okay. Number 7.
I'm going to play Daktari. I'm going to be in the jungle. I'm gonna play with the lions and shit.
Okay. 7 is a tie.
Yes.
Between Beverly Hillbillies and Bewitched.
Out of the two, I would take Bewitched.
Yes. A little more. Although Granny cracked me up.
I just never really got into it.
No. Granny made me laugh.
Great song, though.
Number six, great family show. I can still watch one today.
What is it?
The Andy Griffith Show.
Oh, yeah. Delightful. Aunt B making her pies and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, Aunt B, call the man.
Andy!
Jesus, you're nailing it.
Number 5, Thursday night. Oh, this is crazy. Number 10 was Batman on Wednesday, and number 5 was Batman on Thursday.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Wow.
Nice.
Number 4, the Red Skelton Hour.
Of course, give him an hour.
Yeah. What up?
Hi, boys and girls. Thanks for joining us tonight. Right. We have a great show. Yeah.
Number 3, The Lucy Show.
Oh, not I Love Lucy.
No,
but
The Lucy Show, the color one.
Sure.
I think it was color then. No, maybe not. It had to be because
Disney
was. So
right,
it had
but
to
only
be.
A few could be. That's me.
Oh, okay.
Disney, a few would be in color, so it was like an event.
Right.
in living color. And if you had your black and white set, you just felt like, you know, lions and shit.
Number two?
Yes.
It's making the face.
Number two.
I saw a stroke right here. Number two. I can't do it. Surprise! I can't do it.
Oh, Gomer Pyle.
Gomer Pyle, number two.
Golly!
You're better at Gomer.
Gosh, Sergeant Carter, I did not know you could do that to a chicken.
Pyle! See, I got. Here we go. And number one?
Yes.
Anyone got a guess on number one? From 65.
From the year 1965.
Number one.
Donut.
No. NBC had a 31.8 rating. Gomer Pyle's 27.8, so it's way higher. Bonanza.
Oh, dun.
Ran from 59 to 73, lasting 14 seasons, 431 episodes. Is NBC's longest running Western and ranks overall as the second longest running Western series on U.S. network television and within the top 10 longest running live actions everywhere. You know there's words to that song, right?
I know, but it kind of spoils it.
You think so?
I think so.
It made me laugh.
It doesn't go like, Bonanza, some shit like that.
Hoss and Joe and Adam, no.
Yeah, it's stupid. Stands on its own as an instrumental. I feel.
You know I'm going to jack it up, don't you?
You're going to play the words?
Yeah. Never mind, same one. Never mind. I thought I was going to get the one with the words.
The lyric with the words, yes.
Yeah. Bonanza song. Never mind. Too late.
Too late. It's over.
Oh, Bonanza theme sung by Johnny Cash and Lauren Green.
Johnny Cash.
Oh, wait a minute. We got to do a listen.
Oh, here's one. Here, yeah. Bonanza theme by Lauren Green. Yes.
By Lauren Green. But this one's got Johnny Cash in it.
Oh, boy. A Man Called Sue.
It's going to take long?
Maybe. Sounds like it. Sounds like it might. The claim we hold is the good as gold Bonanza. At this time we built this land upon the Rosa Ranch. Our birthright is this Cartwright Bonanza.
Bonanza.
We here belong and standing strong. Wrong ain't got a chance. We fight the worker play. Ready side by side. Hello, friend. Come on in.
All right, that's enough.
That's enough of that.
So that was number one. All right, so we're going to jump right in. We only got 10 minutes left. We're ripping it up. Top, we got the year-end hot singles for 1965. How many do you want to go?
What do we have? We have 10 minutes.
How many do you think we need?
Let's do top 10.
Top 10?
And we'll embellish.
Man, I don't know. 20 is pretty good.
Well, yeah, but if you have 10 minutes, you know how Dutchie is.
Whatever. It's our radio station.
It's home of the Roy and Jimmy thing.
All right, we'll do top 10.
Top 10.
Top 10, classic. I love it.
What is it?
The Temptations. My Girl.
See, that's beautiful.
See, I think this is right now why we need to do the top 10, because it would be like too long.
The great thing is I will have all these songs.
Yes, you will.
All right, maybe I don't have that one. Okay. Missed it by that much.
That much. I can embellish.
You want to embellish that? There we go. Just do it. It's too good to not do.
Oh, it's because it's an awesome one.
Right.
That's like
the beginning of this.
That's thing. Like, are
oh,
you
wait,
kidding me?
After the ad, of course. My bad. Three,
two, one, go.
And go.
Just the bass line in the beginning? Come on. Don't make me.
You're gonna anyways.
I've got sunshine on a cloudy day.
That's excellent.
When it's cold outside.
Oh my god. Number nine, Elvis Presley, Crying in the Chapel. Who cares?
Don't know it.
Number eight. Oh, this is a good one. I think it's a good one. Number eight, Herman's Hermits. Can't You Hear My Heartbeat? Really? You're going to listen to it. You're going to know.
Yeah, I got to look it up. Cause... Yeah. Can't You Hear My Heartbeat? I'm not familiar with the title. I won't say I'm not familiar with
the title. Who did the heartbeat? It's a love beat. Who did that?
The Silvers in the 70s.
Do you know this one?
Every time I see you looking my way.
Baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat?
Wow. No.
No? That wasn't even in your wheelhouse?
It's not familiar.
Wow. That's a good one. Number 7. All right, here goes the freaking people. One of the most overrated bands in my mind of all time.
It's the Beatles.
Number 7, Help.
That's Evan right there.
Yeah. Sorry, Evan.
Help, I need somebody. Help.
Not just anybody. Help. I need somebody. Help. Whatever. Overrated crap.
And we say goodbye to Evan.
See you, Evan. Have a nice night. Enjoy your pizzas. Oh, man. Wait till you get number 5. Oh. But yep. Here we're at number 6 right now. Number 6, Petula Clark. Downtown.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. But number 5, I'm on it, man.
Let's have it.
Number 5.
Cinco.
The Righteous Brothers.
Fuck, I hate that song.
Do you really?
God.
Ah. You've lost that loving feeling.
Oh, God, I hate that song.
I can't believe you like...
The song irritates me.
Does it really?
That's how much I hate it.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right. All right, we won't even play it then. That's okay. No. You're allowed. I don't even want to talk about it.
It says it is the Roy and Jimmy thing. Give yourself a couple notes. Give yourself. I'm gonna give you a couple notes.
No, I don't want to hear it. Don't want to hear it.
That loving feeling. No. I'm gonna give you a couple notes because it is the Roy and Jimmy thing.
I don't want to hear anything
about
it.
Watch. Here it is. Watch. I'm gonna give you a couple after this Chrysler ad. After this ad from the fine people of the Chrysler Corporation. One of the longer ones here on YouTube.
That's one of the ones you can't skip, right?
Yeah.
You know why a lot of people listen to it? They're getting their money worth.
They're pushing that YouTube red. I'll give you a couple. It's the Roy and Jimmy thing.
When I kiss your lips.
There you go. That's nice.
There's no tenderness like grief or in your fingertips. Okay, that's
there you go. Happy birthday.
There it is. Another. I'm going to make some people mad right here. I think I'm going to really make some people mad.
Jeez, guys. Help, I'm snowed in. Help, needs a...
well, actually, number 4, it's not in my wheelhouse at all.
What is it?
We Five. It's the name of the group. Number 4 was You Were On My Mind.
What's We Five?
I don't know. It's the name of the group.
W-E.
W-E. As in F-I-V-E. F-I-V-E.
You, okay, it comes right up.
It was before the Jackson 5.
I was going to say, they were We. All right, we got a gal, 4 dudes behind her. Excellent and best quality.
Now from the top of the charts, here's that exciting new pop recording group, We Five.
There are 5 people.
All right, well, that's good. This is not even in there.
You were on my
mind. Oh, yeah, it is.
Shit, come on.
Of course it was. We're all there now.
I thought this was like the Association or some shit like that.
That's a one-hit wonder, I'm thinking.
So, got the boots, got the skirt.
Oh, man, that's a good tune. Sorry, We Five.
Sorry, We Five. It's just your name.
Apologize.
That was not an original name of the band.
Was it?
What are You Five going to do? We Five.
We Five.
Not You Five. Yeah. We prefer We Five.
Number 3. I'm going to get some hell for this one, too. The second most overrated band of all time.
The Stones?
Yep. I can't get no satisfaction.
What a classic riff.
Yeah. It is.
Yeah, it's classic riff.
But here it is. I can listen to the Stones, but it's like I just think they're blown up way over the
top.
You know,
I thought that too until I saw them.
Saw them live, and you told me that too.
When I saw them live,
it changed your life.
It changed my view on them.
Okay, I get it.
Yeah,
I get it.
I need just the first few seconds of this thing, just because it's.
Now that is a great riff,
and it sets the era.
Yes, it does.
There, right on, immediately.
Yeah, I want to think of Apocalypse Now.
exactly. It puts you in that time.
Yes, it does. Yes. I agree. Iconic, but not a great band to me. And I'll sing it if it's on the radio.
Exactly.
So I get it.
No, I understand that.
Now, number 2 has to be in there because number 10 was The Temptations. So in that same genre, number 2 comes in.
Mm-hmm.
The Four Tops.
Oh, of course, Four Tops. What's the song?
I thought you were gonna play.
I had tip of my tongue, but I'm ready. I'm ready. Baby, I Need Your Lovin'.
Nope.
Damn it.
I can't help myself.
Really?
Oh, I was number two in 1965.
Well, let's see.
And number one really surprises me, but why not? But I know you're pulling that up now because we're down to four. So we're 4 minutes, so we're good.
Yeah, we're way good. Give it a couple seconds here. Yeah, classic.
Come on.
They're already dancing.
Already. I can smell the polyester burning. Sugar pie, honey bunch. You know that I love you.
Excellent. Oh. Excellent year. We are definitely in the right year.
We were born right where we need to be.
Exactly.
All right. Number one.
Made
a big comeback because of a movie in the 80s.
Ooh.
Huh?
Okay.
Any guesses yet?
Oh, yes.
I'm going to see if you're going to get it. Pull it up and see if you got it.
I got it right here. I hope I am right.
I hope you do.
You broke my
heart.
Damn it.
Because I couldn't dance.
Nope.
All right. I'm out.
Sam, Sham, and the Pharaohs.
Was it Animal House?
No. Spicoli in Fast Times.
Willy Bully.
Yes!
You're talking Willy Bully.
You're talking Willy Bully, aren't you?
You didn't say Willy Bully. That's right, he's up there singing.
He's singing it, doing the... like this?
Yes. After this ad for...
To find people at...
IHOP.
Oh, Pancake Day today.
Pancake Day, of course.
You got to get it in there.
It's appropriate.
Right.
It's appropriate. Yeah, let's see here.
And this is right off Billboard Magazine's Top 100.
Uno, dos.
One, two, tres, cuatro.
I like he's wearing the turban with the medallion. Sam, the Sham, and the Pharaohs. So racist.
Come on, man. And this is kind of a little... that's like... As soon as you hear it, you know what it is, right?
Yeah.
There it is. 1965 Top 10.
Well, there you go. What appropriate song to end our show on.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
Supreme, Stop in the Name of Love. Number 20. Okay, how about Righteous Brothers Unchained Melody?
The worst.
The worst? Okay, that's 21.
Even worse.
What's new, Pussycat? Tom Jones. Did you see that thing Tom Jones sang on The Voice?
Killing it.
Oh, my God. Killed it.
Killed it.
All right. That's it. We're wrapping up.
That's it. We're done.
Happy birthday, brother.
Happy birthday, Roy. It's a birthday week. Thanks for tuning in to the Roy and Jimmy Thing right here on chaoticradio.com, the home of the Roy and Jimmy Thing every Tuesday night. Now, next week, we have comedian Donna Main in.
Yes. We're going
to have our first Tuesday night guest on our new night. So that is next Tuesday, as in every Tuesday, at 8 o'clock Pacific time.
Tuesday. I was looking in the chat room.
You know,
sorry.
I was going to play.
We had Love That One, Play It, Don was. And Dennis says, Sam the Sham's real name was Domingo Zamundio and was actually Mexican-American from Texas, so we can listen to him talk. He has a Texas draw and totally throws you off. thanks, Catherine, Evan, Don, Dennis, Ari. Who else was in there? Someone else was in there. Dang it, I'm missing somebody. I'm looking fast. Anyway, we're out of here. Thank you, everybody, again. Thanks for letting us have some fun here tonight. And we got our guest next week.
Donna Main next week. It is the Roy and Jimmy Thing, like I said, every Tuesday night right here at chaoticradio.com. And don't forget our Sunday replays every Sunday morning, 8 o'clock Pacific time. Your chaotic and coffee being delivered to you now. We have a couple more replay nights coming up. The schedule is getting all set up here, but definitely keep tuning in back to chaoticradio.com for more information and more information on our show and all the other shows right here.
Right on.
There it is. Done.
All right, man.
Happy birthday week. Thanks for listening, and we will talk to you guys next week.
We love you all. Have a safe week. See you here next Tuesday. Hit 'em, baby.